We are back. This is Markets Today. I'm your host, Mbithe Mwema. In studio, we have Madam Esther Moshemi. She is the Chief Executive Officer of Samchi Group. Welcome to the show, Madam Esther Moshemi.
Thank you so much.
So Samchi Group, what is Samchi Group? Tell us a little about yourself and about the Samchi Group as a whole.
Well, Samchi Group of Company, today we call ourselves Samchi Group of Company.
Samchi Group,
but
okay.
When we started, we were Samchi Telecom.
Yes.
And then we started 18 years ago. After I had worked a career, an audit career for okay. more than 10 years, and I decided that I wanted to do something that not only would I engage with myself, but with my family. Because along the way, and with due respect to the professionals, and I honor them,
yes.
I knew professional life sometimes can be limited. And because I wanted to pursue a greatness that was inherent in me, when this opportunity came along the way, without clearly understanding what telecommunication was all about,
yes.
call it a sixth sense, call it a gut feeling,
okay.
I decided to jump into the ship and opened my first shop, which was on Kainange Street.
Yes.
And from that one shop, we have now more than 60 shops. We
Fantastic.
Call them branches, which compose and make the telecommunication business.
Yes.
And we are daring to go.
Okay, so you didn't understand the business that you're in. You just went out on a gut feeling.
I sometimes say so, and yes. that is one characteristic about investors.
Yes.
And I know where consultants are concerned, they want to analyze and overanalyze and
analysis
come with
paralysis.
Business plans and all that and all that.
Yes.
But for me, really, it was not about that. It's just I saw an opportunity.
Okay.
Like what I say, you smell something and you say, I am willing to risk this as much as I don't understand it,
yes.
but I'm willing to take the first step, which is what I encourage, especially the young people, that to the extent that you can understand an idea, try it.
Okay.
Of course, there's a probability that you fail, but there is also a greater probability that you'll be successful.
Oh, wow.
So a lot of us are not getting into investment because we are thinking of, will I make it?
Yes.
You are thinking of huge capital requirement.
That's
for me,
true.
I always say I opened my first shop with 50K.
50,000 in a telco industry
in
that you do not understand.
Industry because after I constructed and set out the shop, honestly, that's the only money I had left.
Wow.
And so out of that 50,000, I bought my first order from Safaricom. And of course, the first few months and years, it was a challenge of buying, selling, banking, getting the same money
wow.
again,
wow.
buying and selling. So for us, where we are, for many years, it is the profit that we made that we invested back to the business.
Oh, fantastic.
And therefore, because it was an issue of investing back the money that you have made.
So this is your surplus that you're putting back into the business.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Call it surplus. I'm not sure it was surplus because the needs are always more.
Okay.
Always more than so what is available.
All right.
So
enough.
There was an element of a lot of sacrifices along the mm-hmm. way. I always say for the first 7 years, I could not even afford to go for a holiday. Neither
wow.
would my family do.
7 years?
Oh, yes, absolutely.
That's a
fact,
very long
the one holiday that I enjoyed somewhere along the line was because Safaricom gifted me
yes.
as the dealer of the year
wow.
to go to South Africa. And you can wow. imagine how much I celebrated that because it gave me a break for 1 week in
okay.
a situation, in circumstances that I could not have afforded to do that. And today we are where we are because of a journey of what I would call A lot of sacrifices.
Yes,
right.
Wow.
Yeah.
But let me ask you, let me just come back. So 7 years you haven't taken a break, or really you have not allowed yourself luxuries. I mean,
yes,
it's really
sure.
the same as just any
mm-hmm.
other investment.
Mm-hmm.
But were you only putting your surplus back into this particular business that you were building,
mm-hmm.
if I may call it an empire,
yes,
or
right.
were you actually putting money into other people's businesses?
To be honest, for the first 10 years,
yes,
I did nothing else outside the telecommunication business. I did not diversify. I did not invest even on anything personal
okay.
that would involve a lot of cash flows, because having a good accounting background, and,
yes,
and today I tell people, whether you are a doctor or an engineer, as long as you want to do businesses and become an entrepreneur,
okay.
it pays
to be
to have a good understanding of accounting. Wow. Because I guess that helped me a lot. And I knew the opportunity cost of me becoming extravagant is that I would retard my growth. So for the first 10 years, I did not invest anything outside.
Wow.
Not only telecommunication, outside Samshi telecommunication.
Okay.
After that, the 10 years, I was able to invest in what I would call your estate, but then in a very small scale.
All right.
Because I would do a lot here, I would do a small building here, okay, and all that, and all that.
So not investing in your own gratification, no, but investing in, no, assets that could give you a return.
Absolutely, absolutely. Okay. And those small pieces of land that I invested then are what has allowed me today,
wow,
to play in the real estate.
So now you have a diversified portfolio in the second decade.
Absolutely, absolutely. So okay, today we are in telecommunication industry. We are four companies in telecommunication. We are in real estate, we are in hospitality,
wow,
after 40 Hotel,
okay,
and Heavenly Foods at Tomboya Street.
Wow.
We are in microfinance, but note that was after the 10 years.
That's after the 10 years.
Because,
okay,
after the 10 years, with the experience, with the structures, with being able to now engage a team of professionals, now I'm here because my companies are still learning.
Okay.
Had you asked me to do this 3 years ago,
it
would have been very difficult
happen,
because,
yes,
I'm the one who was there buying, banking, and doing all sorts of things. But today, because my structure is right, my structure backs me up, my people are right, I can actually be able to diversify much easier and much faster than I was able to do initially. After the 10 years,
yes,
I realized for another almost 5 years or so, plus or take, I would be able to put in a new business, a new investment in a time of 2 years.
All right.
And why is time important for me? Because for every business that I've started, to be honest, I've never had a training about it.
Oh.
So, oh yes. So,
so how do you,
for
do you
me,
just
my things are just strange. But,
<It's>
but
absolutely.
I realize once you establish your values.
Yes.
And you are,
so values are key,
oh,
and
yes,
they don't change
values,
for you as a
they
person.
They don't change. Your principles, your approach
so
towards...
So what are your values? So what would you say as an investor in your own business, because you haven't invested in stocks and,
yes,
other things, what are the key pertinent things
Let
that you need to
you,
bring out?
My values, my key values, and these values for me started first of all as personal values. As I was living them as personal values, I didn't even understand that they were called values. But then I realized, oh, these values that seem to be working for me, I made them my family values.
Wow.
And it's not until the last 4 years that we are now working on them to make them our corporate value.
Okay.
The first value that we respect and we work with is honesty and integrity.
Right.
My life, my success is not about the capital that I've ever had in my business. It's not about even the networks, because networks
so
are also very important.
I can't
important.
Have money and be dishonest and succeed in investing.
First of all, I do believe, yes, you can assume you are successful,
okay,
but this is what I believe.
So honesty and integrity.
Wealth and prosperity that is not based on values, because the values and principles give it a foundation,
yes,
a foundation that will allow it to go into the second generation,
oh,
and
wow,
into the third generation.
So legacy. So you're actually
Absolutely.
Leaving a legacy. So honesty and integrity
it
is
one of them. Of course, we also believe in being in focus and consistency, because we are what we are because we have been focused in what we want to do at every particular time. We've been consistent, and
how
it's very difficult for you to,
yes,
get us out of that.
But Madam Esther,
yeah,
how do you remain focused? Because I can understand, you see, hindsight is always 20/20.
Yes,
when,
right,
we are discussing that you said you stayed in telecoms for 10 years.
Yes.
When you're starting a business, I want to imagine your motivation was, I want to put 1 shilling, and hopefully if it grows to 2, to 3, to 100, the better. You are looking for a profit.
To be honest, that is never
is it
what drives me.
Okay, so what was the driver?
And with time, I have confirmed that profit and making money, if it is what makes you want to get into the business, I can almost guarantee you,
okay,
it's a recipe for disaster.
Are you serious?
Oh, yes, absolutely.
Explain.
For me, one of the things that I have come to confirm,
yes,
in my work is, and I have talked about it in my book,
All
I
right.
am the author of Give Me My Mountain
oh, wow.
book.
All right.
I have talked about it, and one of the, what I have confirmed is the why is very important.
The why.
The why of what you do. And of course, let me tell you what excites me today as I do my investment is being an employer.
Oh, wow.
You know, okay. That excites me.
That's a first.
Yeah.
Everyone says, I'm happy to be an investor because I've made money and I've left a legacy for my future families.
That excites me. Of course, the fact that I am able to identify a problem and give a solution. And in the process of giving a solution, I'm able to impact a lot more people. I.e., I am saying, a business that is about me and about me and about me alone,
no.
Doesn't excite me.
But were you always like that when you were starting up 18 years ago? Or did you grow into that?
I didn't know I was like that. But now when I look back, I realize that there is something almost inherent in my character that allows me to reach out to getting, to giving solutions, to being able to reward myself last because all this
reward yourself last. Does that mean you didn't pay yourself
for
a salary?
Long time.
Is this a good investment? What if it didn't go well?
You know what?
Yes.
I'm never scared of failing.
Okay.
Because even the Bible says, a righteous man will fall seven times,
true,
but he'll wake up again.
And he will still
so
rise.
So for me, one thing I know today as an investor, fear is not one of the, fear of failure is not one of those things that will be in the forefront as I am wanting to establish my business. Yet having said that, oh my God, my greatest fear is actually failure.
So have you failed?
Oh, yes.
Tell us, what has been your greatest failure as an investor in Kenya? And how did you bounce back? Because, I mean, it's very interesting when I'm just listening to you. So you're defining the traits of any investor.
Yes.
Because I think at times we're so focused on, I want to put 100 shillings and I want it to double. Mm. But you forget there's a way that the investment process builds your character.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely. And if you want to build a long-term business, a long-term investment, you have to start from point A to point Z, and they are in other alphabets in between.
Yes.
What people sometimes forget is to know as you start in point A, there is a Z, but there is a journey.
Yes.
So for me, it's about recognizing that every journey that I take, every investment that I take, there will be a journey. And I start with knowing, yes, there is an end game.
Okay.
An end game is, for example, let me tell you about the After 40.
All right.
It's one hotel today.
Okay.
But in the memorandum, just to be as basic as that, I have talked about After 40 hotels. In my mind, I know there will be hotels.
Yes.
So what I am doing now is I'm establishing a foundation and a strong foundation that will not only allow me to get into the many After 40 hotels. Mm-hmm. Hotels.
Okay.
And if in the unlikely event, because I cannot live forever, you know, my children, and not only my children, my biological children, even the generations that are after me, because if there's one thing I enjoy is calling out the young generation to get into the future, even then, they will be able to create other After 40s, they'll be able to create other Samchi telecoms or whatever else they'll do because we have established a foundation, holding all things constant and God being on our side, they are strong enough. So for me at the moment, and I'll tell you this with no fear of contradiction, what I'm focusing a lot at the moment is not even to make the billions and the millions, it's just to create a foundation because I know if that is right, the millions and the billions will follow me.
Wow. I mean, this is very interesting. We'll take a short break. But what you're effectively telling me is an investment should not really be about making money. There's more to it. There's a journey to it.
Yes, there's a journey to it.
Madam Esther, we take a short break.
Yes.
The NSC has just closed. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back in a few.